We've been talking about high winds and dealing with extremely high winds, you know, winds in excess of 20 to 30 miles an hour. But little bit of wind, let's talk about a 10 mile an hour wind, or even less, a 5 mile an hour wind, and how that can impact your day very positively a lot of times. You know, if you're out fishing a dead, calm, slick day and you're not getting a lot of bites, a lot of times the first thing that I'm gonna try to do is find a big point or some structure that's got a little bit of wind coming across it. I believe that breaks up the surface a little bit, kind of stirs that food chain up, gets the phytoplankton moving, gets the bait fish moving, may even blow the bait fish in there. And I remember a trip on Choke Canyon fishing, I'd struggle, not getting any bites, gone to the back of the creeks, gone to the, main lake points, couldn't get a bite, just really couldn't get anything going. Started running common community holes, the South Shore Boat Ramp, one of the most common community holes on Choke Canyon. There was just a little bit of northwest wind kind of blowing into that bank right there on that big community hole point right there. Kind of came around it, throwing a Ruku shad, and once I found some, dropped the power pole down, hit the anchor lock, man, I started catching them. Oh, Ruku shad, doing some work. Oh yeah, God, that's such a fun bite, when they bite like that. Oh, barely got you hooked, but we got you. How healthy that fish is. I mean, little old mouth, big old body. That's the way we like to see them. You know, we've really struggled down here so far today. Now we're starting to get some action. That's part of fishing. You've got to go through the trials and tribulations and the failures to start catching them. Boy, that's a big old chunk. We're going to get that back, see if we can catch another one on that same spot.